गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
मॉर्निंग
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
सर, मल्टीडिसिप्लिनरी एंड इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच ऑफ मैकेट्रॉनिक्स, एडवांटेजेस डिसएडवांटेजेस एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ मैकेट्रॉनिक्स सर।
ओके, वी आर गोन अप टू एप्लीकेशंस राइट। हैव वी
यस
डन
सर।
अबाउट द सिस्टम, अबाउट रिगार्डिंग सिस्टम, हैव वी डन
सिस्टम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स वी हैव यू हैव एक्सप्लेन सर।
ओके ओके गुड। ओके राइट, so we should just proceed now. Okay, so only four are there. Okay, I think we are expecting another one or two. Okay, right now. Okay, I think last class we had discussed about what do you mean by a system. Okay, so I think we have understood system is nothing but what was the definition we had discussed? System is nothing but what was that? System is a what is system? Okay, basically system is nothing but it's a block box. Can you able to hear me? No issue.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. A system is considered as a black box which is having a some type of the input, and we are going to get the desired output. Okay. Now, basically, when we consider mechatronics as the technology, it generally involves definitely more than a system. Okay. So any mechatronic system is going to have more than one number of the system. So the system is consists of the group of elements. Generally, system consists of the group of elements or certain devices combined to achieve the required or desired output. Okay, now why we have made the system is we have made a group of elements which are required to achieve a desired type of the output. Okay, for various different types of inputs. Okay, now in order to understand the relationship between in order to understand the relationship between the inputs and the outputs, we are going to call this as what is called as a system. Okay, we are going to consider what is called as a mechatronics system. Now a broad classification of the mechatronic system is we call it as a basic system or a pure systems. Okay, we call it as basic system or a pure system, or the other one is called as the combined system or which is called as the combination of one or more system. Okay, so when you consider a basic system, the basic systems are going to be a mechanical system, electrical system, electronic system, control system. So these are all the basic systems all about. Okay, right. Then if you go for a combined system, so in the combined system we are having hydraulic system, electromechanical system, thermomechanical system, measurement system and control system. Okay, that means in hydraulic system you will be having mechanical energy as the input and the hydraulic parameter as the output. Okay, or in case of measurement system we will be having input as the value to be measured and the output as value of that particular quantity. Okay, right. Now you take an example of a motor. In case of a motor, input is what? Input what you are going to give is the electrical energy. Okay, you are going to give the electrical energy which leads to the rotation of the shaft. Okay, so rotation of the shaft is what type of energy? Rotation of the shaft is mechanical energy. Therefore,
mechanical energy.
Motor is a case of a electromechanical system. Okay, motor is the case of electromechanical system. Or you take an example of an engine. Okay, for the engine, what is the energy? Input energy.
Chemical energy.
To start the engine, what is required? Fuel. Okay,
fuel,
means
sir.
What type of means fuel is going to be burned, correct? Na, fuel is going to be burned. Means what is that energy? It's a in heat energy, correct? La, okay, it's a heat energy. When you give the heat energy, what is going to happen? What is the mechanical output? What is the output? Sorry. What is the output? Output is measured in terms of mechanical means, correct? So it means nothing but see thermomechanical engines. Okay, you consider thermomechanical engine. Or take an example of steam turbine. Okay, so probably you can understand steam turbine. Okay, what is the input for the steam turbine?
Steam.
Steam. Okay, so steam is nothing but what? temperature or the heat. Okay, what is the output of the steam turbine? Rotation of the shaft. Correct or what? Okay. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is type of thermomechanical system. Okay, so if you take an example of water turbine, so water is the inlet, water is the input, and output is the rotation of the shaft. So it's a hydromechanical system. Means what I mean to say here, now there are possibility of combination of the systems are going to occur. Okay, now we'll proceed with what is called as a measurement system. Okay, right. So what is a measurement system? What is a measurement system? What is the measurement system?
A system which is having collection of measurement units.
Okay. What are the components of are the elements of measurement system?
Like various types of measurements.
What are the components?
Input, sensor, signal conditioner, display.
Signal conditioning and display. I think briefly we have discussed that in the last class. Okay, right. So this will be to understand now. Okay, maybe on a larger scale. Okay, right. Now, okay, once again, I'll just present it now. Okay, right. Once again, I'm just getting some issue here. Window, it's not coming. Okay. Once again, no, it's not coming. Okay. Be able to see this?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Element of measurement.
Elements of measurement system. Okay, right. Now, if you consider elements of measurement system, so as we understood, so the first one is called as the sensor or the transducer. Okay. Second one is the signal conditioning, and third one is the display. Okay, right. Now, in for a measurement system, okay, what is the input that we are going to get? The input for a measurement system is what?
A sensor.
Okay, the input for the measurement system. Okay, now all this put together, we call it as what is called as a measurement system. Okay, right? For all this put together, we call it as a measurement system. The input for the measurement system is called as what is called as the quantity being measured. Okay, it's also called as what? It's also called as what? Tell me. I think this we have done somewhere, if I am correct. Have we done this or not? Yes or no?
Yes.
Have we done this or not? Huh?
So.
What is this called? Input to the measurement system is called as the measurand. Okay, input to the measurement system is called as the measurand. And the output is going to be called as the value of that particular measurand. The output is going to be called as the value of that particular measurand. Okay, right. Now take an example of a voltmeter. Okay, what is the input to be measured? The input is nothing but the potential difference. Okay, if it is a voltmeter, the input is going to be potential difference. What is the output of the voltmeter? The output of the voltmeter is the voltage. Okay, right. If you take an example of a thermocouple, input is going to be the difference in temperature. Okay, the output is going to be what? The output is going to be the value, which is called as electromotive force. Okay, right. So R, if you take an example of a digital tachometer, okay, you take an example of a tachometer, the bike. Okay, if you can take an example of a bike, okay, there you have a tachometer or a speedometer, you call it as. Earlier you used to have an analog speedometer. Nowadays all bikes is generally coming with a digital tachometer. Okay, what is the input for digital tachometer?
Revolution of the
shaft. Revolution, it is the rotation of the shaft. Okay, some mechanism is going to be there with which as and when the tire rotates, that has taken their rotation, and that rotation is the input to your digital tachometer. What is the output of a digital tachometer? What is the output of a digital tachometer?
Shows the values.
It shows the value on a screen. Okay, it shows the value on the screen, which is nothing but some 1500 RPM or 200 RPM or 100 RPM, depending upon the case. Okay, so that is the first one. Okay, right. Next is with this understanding. Okay, now we'll take what is called as the brief discussion on this. So sensor, elements of a measurement system, consists of, it is a process of acquiring the data. Okay, please understand carefully. It's a process of acquiring the data, okay, from the outside surroundings, and measure, after acquiring, measure efficiently or measure precisely, and then give a output which is going to be present on the display monitor. Okay, so that is the broad elements of measurement system all about. Okay, right. Now if you take one by one, that is sensors are the transducer. Okay, so basically a sensor is a device. What it does sensor, it senses and transforms physical phenomenon into another form of energy. Okay, that means a sensor is a device which senses and transforms the physical phenomenon to be measured from one form of energy to another form of the energy. Okay, so that is a basic understanding of what is called as a sensor. Okay, right. If you take an example of any sensor, okay, take an example of a pressure gauge. Okay, in case of pressure gauge, what is the input that you are going to give? What is the input that you are going to give? Input is pressure. For the pressure gauge, the input is going to be pressure. Okay, so what pressure gauge does? It takes the pressure. It takes the input as the pressure, and it gives the output in the form of displacement. Okay, so that means, so some medium is going to be there. Okay, some diaphragm is going to be there. If you give more pressure, the diaphragm is going to expand. Are you understanding what I am telling? Yes or no? The diaphragm is going to expand. Okay, so expand in a sense, what is that you are measuring there? Expand means, what is that mechanical parameter you measure?
Displacement.
Very good. Okay, you are going to measure what is called as a displacement. That means pressure is converted into what is called as a displacement. Okay, which is in the form of mechanical. Okay, now again, take an example of a thermocouple. Okay, in thermocouple, input is going to be the heat, means difference in temperature between the cold junction and the hot junction. Output is going to be what? Output is going to be EMF. Okay. Now, this is the job of a sensor or a transducer. Simple, sensor or transducer is nothing but a device which converts, which detects changes in phenomenon and converts from one form of the energy into another proportional form of the energy. So this is called as a sensor or a transducer. Okay, right. Now, I think somewhere I told, okay, I am explaining in a detailed way we are explaining now. Second component was called as a signal conditioning. Okay. Now, this is the second component, okay, which is in between the sensor and display. Okay, now I have sensed the data, right? I have sensed the data, it should go to display. That's all, no? Okay, after sensing the data, it should go to display. What is this fellow is doing in between is the question. Okay, what is this fellow is doing is basically the signal conditioning are called as intermediate modifying element. Please understand, please note it down somewhere. Okay, signal conditioning devices are called as intermediate modifying elements or intermediate modifying devices. Okay, it is also called as signal modifiers. Please note down, it's also called as signal modifiers, or it's also called as signal manipulators. Okay, it's also called as the signal manipulator, signal modifiers, or signal modifying devices, or signal conditioning devices, or intermediate modifying devices. Okay, right. What it does is important. Okay, it receives the signal from where? It receives the signal from the sensors and transducer and manipulates, okay, means or modify, so that the signal is going to be displayed on the display. Are you understanding now? What it does, it manipulates in a sense, it modifies. Okay. So manipulate, don't think it does some nonsense. Okay. So it manipulates or it modifies the output of the sensor for the purpose of what? For the purpose of getting it suitable. Okay. For the purpose of getting making the signal suitable for the purpose of display and then for the purpose of control. Okay, right. So this is what is the case. Okay, right. Now, generally, what are the purposes of a signal conditioning? What are the activities it does? Okay, so signal conditioning is going to be used, okay, for the various activities like what is called as amplification of the signal. That is, I think I had told earlier, it is used to amplify the signal obtained from the sensors. Okay, so the output of the sensor is going to be a smaller value, so I need to give more energy to it. Therefore, I am going to use signal conditioning devices. Okay, so once a signal conditioning devices was called as the amplifiers, are called as the operational amplifiers, are simply called as op amps. Okay, now I will use the op amps. So what op amps does is, op amps is called as a voltage manipulator or voltage amplifying device. Okay, so what it does, if I give 2 volts, it does certain process there and it gives you 10 volts. Okay, what is the rating of the amplifier there, or what is the gain of the amplifier? Quickly, I have given 2 volts, I am going to get 10 volts. What is the gain of the amplifier? Come on, I have given 2 volts.
Eight amps.
No, I have given 2 volts, and I, after amplification, I am getting 10 volts. What is the gain of the amplifier?
2.
What is V out by V in? Hey, come on, yaar. What is V out, yaar?
Sir, 10 volts, sir.
10 volts. What is V in, yaar?
2 volts.
Okay, what is the gain? Gain is nothing but what? Voltage gain is nothing but it is the ratio of the output voltage to the input voltage. Simple. What is the gain?
8 volts.
4, sir.
What is the output voltage? Yeah, 10 volts, na?
10.
Yes, sir.
10. Okay. Input voltage is 2 volts.
5, sir. 5 volts, sir.
That's all. No? V out is equal to 10 volts. Okay. V in will be what? Okay. V in will be equal to 2 volts. Okay. Gain is nothing but what? Gain is nothing but V out divided by V in. Okay. Right. So the gain of the amplifier is going to be what? 10 divided by, this is 2. Okay. 10 divided by 2, it is 5. Means, okay. Now, 5 times the input voltage is going to be given by that amplification. Okay. So that is one thing. Then, that is about amplification of the signal. Okay. Then, second one very important thing is, the output of the sensor consists of larger number of noises. Okay. Output of the sensor consists of larger number of the noise. So what I have to do for the display, I don't want all the noise to be supplied. Okay. Therefore, I will use, okay, I will use what are called as the filters. Okay. I'm going to use what are called as the filters. Okay. Now that process is called as the filtering process. Okay. Therefore, filter is nothing but, filter is a process of reducing or process of eliminating certain type of the frequencies. Okay, filter is a process of reducing or eliminating certain type of the frequency by not going to the display. Okay, that is called as your the filtering all about. Okay, right. Then next we have what is called as the A bar D converter. What is A bar D converter? Any idea? Analog to digital converters. Okay. Why analog to digital converter is required is very, very important. Okay, right. Now you got the sensor now. Okay, right. Voltmeter is a sensor. Assume. Okay, voltmeter is a sensor. Okay, what is the output of the voltmeter? Okay, what is the output of the voltmeter?
Voltage.
Okay, how the voltage is measured? The voltage is measured something like this. Can you able to understand? What is this?
Okay.
A pointer. Okay. Can you able to understand what I wrote? Okay. The output, what is that I am reading is, it's in the form of pointer. Are you understanding? So this is 5 volt, this is 0 volt, this is 10 volt. Are you getting my point? Okay. Yes. But I want to convert this into, okay, a digital signals. Okay. Right. So now assume in that case, analog signal has to be converted into digital signal. Hence, I am going to use what are called as the analog to digital converter. Okay, right. Similarly, on the contrary, okay, the output obtained from the sensor might be a digital value that may have to be given to the analog, display. Okay, in that case, I have to convert digital into analog. Therefore, the possibility of signal conditioning is going to be number one, amplification of the signal. Number two, filtering process. Number three, analog to digital conversion. Number four, digital to analog conversion. Okay, now these are all the signal conditioning activities. Okay, then we had what is called as display. Display is a simple mechanism wherein you are going to show the output of the value that you got. Okay, that's all. Okay, so you are going to show the output of the value that you got. Okay, right. So this is something called as your the elements of a measurement system. Okay, right. Now, yeah, we'll just take a simple example now. Okay, one example of what is called as a thermocouple we'll take. Okay, right. So in case of thermocouple, what is it I am having now? Okay, right. Now, if you observe, so this is what is the thermocouple what I am having. Okay, right. Okay, now this is your cold junction. Okay, this is your hot junction. So this is going to be called as your T1. Okay, this is going to be called as your T2. Okay, right. Now, from this, you are going to take the input. Okay, right. Okay, right. So what is this one called as? What is this sensor called as? What is this one? What is this? Which element of your measurement system is this?
Sensor.
Thermocouple.
What is the sensor name?
Thermocouple.
Okay, so you got the sensor now. Okay, right. Now, what has happened now? So this you have got. Now I am going to send this to where? Send this to this. Okay, so if you understand, so this in detail you are going to understand this later, no issue. So we'll send it to a device. What is this device called as? This device is called as the amplifier. Okay, right. And then this amplifier, I am going to send it to what is called as the A bar D converter. Okay, right. Okay, right. Then from here. So what is this combiningly called as? What is this combiningly called as?
Amplification, sir.
Huh?
Amplification.
Amplification. And also this is amplification. This one is analog to digital conversion. Okay. So this is what element? This is a sensor. Correct? This is a sensor. What is this one called as? Second element?
Amplifier.
No. This is amplifier, correct. We have amplifier and also A bar D. Now, what is this? What are these called as? Which comes under what heading?
Signal conditioning.
Okay, this comes under what is called as the signal conditioning. Okay, it comes under what is called as signal conditioning. Okay, then, so this will be given to where? This will be given to what is called as a display. Okay, so you are going to show the display on the monitor. Okay, so 54 degrees Celsius. So this is called as what? This is called as your the display. Okay, right. Now, a simple example of what is called as your a measurement system, which consists of a sensor in the form of thermocouple. Sensor is a thermocouple here. Then signal condition is going to be there. Signal condition is going to be number one is amplifier is one signal conditioning, and other one is called as your the analog to digital converter is the signal conditioning. Okay. So after that, it gives to the display. The display is going to be in the form of the digital form. Okay. The display, what is that I am getting, is in the form of what is called as the digital display. As it is a digital display, I have used what was called as the analog to digital converter. Okay, so this is what is the case of what is called as the measurement system. Okay, so now we'll try to understand something called as transducers and sensors, and then we'll come back. Okay, now before we go into control system, okay, anything?
No.
Nothing. Okay. Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, right. Now this is about the sensors or transducer. Before I take you to the control system, I just want to say something related to the concept of sensors. Okay, so that it's easy for us to go for the control system. Okay, right. Now at this point of time, we know what you mean by a sensor or a transducer. Okay, basically it converts from one form of the energy to another form of the energy. Okay. Now, when you want to buy a sensor or a transducer, when you want to buy or when you want to procure sensors or a transducer, some 6-7 performance terminologies are going to be used. Okay, so very, very basic thing, okay, which is very important. That's why I'm taking this now. Okay, now what are those performance terminologies? Number one is called as the range. Okay, can just don't observe this, this slide. What do you mean by a range of the sensor or a range of a transducer? Basically, range of a transducer is the limits between which the inputs can go into be vary. Okay, that is the range of a transducer is the limits between which the input can vary. That is called as a range. Okay. Now, what is the range of your the vernier caliper that you have used? Can anybody say range of the vernier caliper? Tell me, range of the vernier caliper is how much? Have you used vernier caliper?
Yes, sir.
Used, na? Have you used?
Sir, it will be 300 mm, sir.
No, range is 300 mm?
Yes, sir.
Wrong. You can't say range. Range. I am using the word range.
Accuracy.
No, 300 mm is correct. Please, no, I am very, very specifically asking. Range means what? What do you mean by range? Is range is a single number or two? There should be two numbers. Simple. First thing. Common sense.
Two numbers, sir.
Always. Remember. This is very, very important. Okay. Because there is one more thing which is associated with that. That's why I am making specifically. Range is nothing but it is the limits. Okay. Understand carefully. It is the limits between which. Okay. It is the limits between which the inputs can vary. Okay. Now, the range of the micrometer or the range of the what you call as your the vernier caliper is 0 to 150 mm. That means the values can vary from 0 to 150 millimeter. Okay. If you take an example of a micrometer, okay. Now the range of the micrometer is 0 to 25 mm. One such range. Okay. Right. Now here one example has been given. Okay. Thermocouple. Okay. The range is 25 to 225. Means minimum value that you can measure is 25 degrees Celsius and the maximum value that you can able to measure is 225 degrees Celsius. The range is 25 to 225 degrees Celsius. Now, similar to the range, extract of the range is called as the span. What is span? Span is nothing but it is the difference between maximum value that you can measure to the minimum value that you can measure. Okay, right. Now you take an example of this. Okay, so if you take an example of 0 to 150, what is the maximum that you can measure? 150. Minimum you can measure 0. Therefore, what is the range? What is the span of this vernier caliper? The span of this vernier caliper is 150 mm. Okay, please understand the basic difference. Range is the two values, 0 to 150. Span is 150. Now here in this case, range was 25 to 225 degrees Celsius. What was the span? Span is
200, sir. 200 degrees Celsius.
Span is 225 minus 25. It is 200 degrees Celsius. The span of your the thermocouple. Okay, right. Now, what is the error? Next thing is very important. Is error. Okay. So, what do you mean by error? Error is the difference between the measured value and the true value. Okay, the error is nothing but is the difference between the measured value and the true value. That means you are supposed to measure 200 degrees. Let's assume that you need to measure the body temperature, human body temperature, it was 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, right. Now, this is what is the actual value of actual body temperature of a healthy human being. Okay, now I have measured, okay, the value as 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, right. So this is the measured value. So this is going to be called as my measured value. So this is going to be called as my actual value. Therefore, error is going to be what? Error is nothing but it is the difference between the measured value and that of the actual value. Therefore, that means 35 minus 37 minus 2 degrees Celsius is called as your the error. Okay. Now, to compensate the error, what is that you are going to give? How can you compensate this error? How much you need to add to this?
Point.
Point. Point two, na? No, no. For this example, for this 37-35 example.
2 degrees Celsius.
Two degrees Celsius. What is the 2 degrees Celsius called as? What is that parameter called as?
Error, sir.
No, no. Error is minus two. Okay. 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 Now error is. Okay. Now error was. Okay. Right. Actual value is. Okay. Actual value is 37. Okay. Measured value is 35. Okay. Right. So error. Error is going to be equal to measured minus actual. It is minus 2 degrees Celsius. Okay. Right. Now you will compensate this by adding a number called as 2 degrees Celsius. What is this 2 degrees called as? What is this called as? Anybody? What is the opposite of error? Okay, I think you might have forgotten. This is called as what?
Correlation.
Correction. Okay, this is called as correction. Okay, means error and correction magnitude wise, both of them are
opposite, sir.
No, no, magnitude, magnitude. Magnitude wise, both of them are same, correct? Magnitude is same, 2 and 2, but only change is the sign. Okay, if error is going to be minus 2 degrees Celsius, correction is going to be 2 degrees Celsius. Okay, right. So that's about the error. Then accuracy. Yeah, now accuracy is nothing but what? Accuracy defines the closeness of the agreement between the actual measurement. Okay, how close? The accuracy is nothing but how close the actual, how close the measured value is to the actual value, okay, is what is called as the accuracy. That means in the previous case, okay, now 37 is what we need to measure, okay, and I have got what is called as 35, okay. What is this, the closeness? The closeness of this is called as the accuracy. Now, assume that the next slide, I'll just go further. Okay, now one more entity I'll just try to give so that it's easy for you. Okay, right. Now, right, we'll go like this. Okay. Now, the accuracy is going to be plus or minus 3 voltage. Right. Please observe, the actual value is going to be 30 volts. Actual value is 30 volts. Accuracy of my device is plus or minus 3 volt. What do you mean by this? Anybody can say? Actual value that I am supposed to measure is 30 volt. Accuracy of my device is plus or minus 3 volts. Okay. What is the infer that you are going to make it?
The output will be of plus or minus 3 degrees.
From where? From where?
Actual value.
Okay, now simple, the reading, the measuring device is accurate up to plus or minus 3 volts to what? Plus or minus 3 volts with reference to your actual value. That means you are going to say, yes, the readings are okay if it is ranging between 27 volts to 33 volts. Means if the reading is going to be between 27 volts to 33 volts, you are going to say the system is okay because the accuracy itself is plus or minus 3 volts. Is it clear now? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. Now another thing is, okay, right. Now I am going to read from 0 to 200. Let's assume like this. Okay. 0 to 200 degree Celsius. Okay, the temperature is going to read from 0 to 200. Okay, now some value I am going to read. Now I am going to express the accuracy in some other way. What is that some other way? Plus or minus 2% of full range Okay, now you tell me. Okay, please understand. I am just going with other way. Okay, this is one method of expressing the accuracy. Okay, that is plus or minus 3 volts. Another method of expressing accuracy is plus or minus 2% of full range deflection. Full range deflection. What is your accuracy? Are you understanding what is that I am writing? The accuracy of the device is plus or minus 2% of full range deflection. Okay. Now, what is the full range deflection here?
200.
No, full range deflection is how much?
0 to 200.
Are you understanding? So the accuracy is plus or minus 2% of full range. Okay. So means what is that you are going to get? 2/100 multiplied by, what is the full range deflection?
200, sir.
200. Okay. Right. What is the value now? Plus or minus in terms of value now? What is this? Plus or minus?
4 degrees Celsius.
Are you understanding what I'm telling? I can express, in getting it out, I can express directly as plus or minus 3 volts. If the actual value is 30 volts, it is 27 volts to 33 volts. The other way of expression, this is first method. The other way of expressing the accuracy is plus or minus some percentage of full range deflection. Okay. Now my full range deflection is 0 to 200. I have told plus or minus 2%. So it is going to vary between plus or minus 4 degrees Celsius. Now, the full range deflection is assumed it is going to be 500 degrees Celsius. Okay. Assume it is 500 degrees Celsius. Now, what has happened now? What is the accuracy of my device? Plus or minus?
10.
Plus or minus? Okay, my accuracy of the device is plus or minus 10 degrees Celsius. Are you understanding? Yes or no? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is what is called as the expression of accuracy. Okay, right. Now, I have somewhere here. Okay, there is one more thing I'd like to say. Okay, accuracy is done. Precision. What do you mean by precision? Can I say? What do you mean by precision? What do you mean by precision?
Getting the same value again and again. Sir.
Testing the... Tell me.
Getting
tell me
the
again.
Same no. Output.
Sir,
getting the same output.
Repeatability of the instruments.
Okay, means precision is nothing but how close the measured value themselves. Okay, means accuracy is what? How close the measured value is to the actual value. Is it clear? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Accuracy is how close the measured value is to the actual value. Okay. Precision is how close the measured value to it again and again. Means now at this point of time, okay, now I am measuring, okay, the temperature at this point of time, okay, right. Then again, somebody at some other location, now I have point number A, I have measured temperature, then again I am going to measure point number B, point number C, okay. Now all this is the same device, let us say in the same device I am measuring the temperature. Do you expect the temperature of the device to be same? Okay, R, assume, okay. Now, at this point of time, what is the time? We'll all check with the with our own watch, okay. What should be the measured value? Is it should be same or it should be different?
Same.
It should be same, means what? How close the measured values when you make a repetitive measurement of the same value, at the same time, if you make repetitive measurement, okay. Daily at 10 o'clock, you check the time. Okay. So today 10 o'clock, tomorrow 10 o'clock, day after tomorrow 10 o'clock. Okay. At all the time, you should get the same value. It means the system is precise. Okay. Now you tell me in your measurement system. Okay. Now you come to measurement system. That is sensor. Okay. You want the sensor to be, okay. You want to build a measurement system now. The first part of the measurement system is buying a sensor. Now you thought of buying a sensor. Okay. Now the range of the sensor is fixed, the accuracy is, everything is known to you, okay, fine, everything is fine. Now you want the measurement device, okay, to be accurate or you want it to be precise? You want the measurement device to be accurate or to be precise?
Both, sir.
What?
Both, sir.
Both. Okay, how many of you say both?
Yes, sir. Both should be there.
Okay, right. Now remember, it is very, very important that any device, it should be accurate and also it should be precise. Okay, that means the closeness of the measured value to the true value should be as less as possible. Closeness should be as small as possible. If it is very close, error is going to be more or less?
Less, sir.
Very less.
Okay. Less, sir.
If the closeness is very small, the error is going to be less. And those, the value that you measure repetitively, all the repetitive value should fall in the, this should fall on the same target. Okay, every time you need to hit the same target. Okay, then you can say the precision is going to be correct. Okay, so that is one thing. Then next is what is called a sensitivity. Okay, very important. Okay, so what do you mean by sensitivity? Sensitivity is nothing but, okay, simple definition of sensitivity, it is a ratio of output by input. Okay, it is a ratio of output by input. Okay, it means that you are given some input value, okay, to the device. Is the device is picking all the input value to give the output? Okay. Now, what do you expect sensitivity to be? You want sensitivity to be 100% or you want sensitivity to be lesser than 100%?
Lesser than.
What do you want the sensitivity to be? More or less? Tell me like this.
More.
Less. Less, sir.
Huh?
Less, sir.
No, no. Okay, understand. The sensitivity of the instrument, the ideal value of sensitivity of the instrument should be 100%. Okay, I'll tell you why. The ideal value should be 100%. Means what? You are given some type, some amount of input. Okay, all the input should be taken into the system for the measurement of output. Okay, are you understanding? Okay, understanding? If some input is going to be lost, if the sensitivity is lesser, it means what? Some input quantity is lost. Okay. Are you going to get the output which is equivalent to input value?
No.
No, sir.
Because you have measured the output by considering some portion of the input. Some portion of input has lost somewhere in between. Maybe some loss, some temperature loss has occurred. There you lost the some value of the input. Okay. Now, the output of what you have measured is not the exact indication of the input. Okay. You understood now? Understood clearly? Right? Now? Yes or no?
Yes.
Clear? Okay. So, the input should completely get transformed into the output. If input is not transformed to the output, you are going to get what is called as a loss. That loss should not supposed to occur. That is called as the sensitivity. Okay. Right. Okay. Right. Now, next, we have what is called as, okay, right, the resolution. What is the time now? Okay, so 11:41. Okay. 11:40, 45 you have to go for the class. Okay, right. We'll stop at this stage. Okay, right. Now, quickly, somebody can say what is that we have done? Quickly.
Sir,
quickly.
Measurement system, okay. Sensors, signal conditioner, filter.
Okay.
Analog to this signal conditioner, what are the signal conditioner types of signal okay. conditioners? And
Sukrat.
Yes,
what do you mean by span? Quickly.
Span. The span is the difference between the maximum and minimum value of the input, sir.
Okay. Mohan Ambal.
Yes, sir.
What is accuracy? What is accuracy?
Accuracy is the closeness between the actual measurement, that is to the true value. The measured value, how close it is to the new true value.
Okay. Right. Shriyarsha? Shriyarsha, what is error? What is error?
Error is the difference between the measured value and the accurate value.
Measured value and the accurate value.
The accurate value.
Okay. Dhanush, what,
yes,
what is precision? What is precision?
Sir,
situation is how repeatedly the measurement the instrument can measure the same value with respect to the true value, sir.
Okay, right. Now the accuracy of the device is plus or minus 10 volts.
Yes, sir.
Okay, 10 volts. What is your inference?
The true value can vary between between plus or minus 10 value with respect to the true value, sir.
True value can vary or measured value can vary.
Measured value can vary with plus or minus 10 volts with respect to the true value, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, any issue? Okay, I'm just going slow. Okay, maybe as and when I just start with, I'll be going faster to complete the thing. Any doubts here?
No, sir.
Okay, right. No, sir. Now, as I have come with the sensors, I also covering the terminologies with respect to sensors. Okay, that's why I brought this concept now. Okay, right. So now we'll just stop at this stage now. Okay, right. And we'll come and meet in the next class. Okay, right. Thank you.
Thanks.